because we don't have any friends.
No friends.
How much do you think this thing costs?
£50.
Close. Go. Very good, Craig. $59.95. Pretty cool. And if you have any thoughts on any of these items whatsoever, send us an email to this address. It is thekit@bbc.co.uk. Charlie.
Thanks, Gia. Now, goths. We've all seen them in the clubs, looking like Edward Scissorhands, but with fingers. Well, I love them. And one goth I particularly love is John the Goth. He's very tall, very clever, and very gothy. We gave him a challenge, which was to build us a top-spec computer, which in the shops might set you back about a grand, for about 400 quid. Let's see how he got on.
The first thing you think I might do to get my computer is to go down to the local high street. But every day, hundreds of computers are thrown away onto skips. In fact, there's one just over there now. Now, first of all, don't just jump into anyone's skip. You have to ask them permission first. What have we got here? Surprise, surprise. There's loads of computer bits. Look, an old monitor. Hey, a keyboard. Some very strange speakers. And a nest of dead mice.
Well done, our goth chum has found us lots of free goodies. Now, even if that old computer was new, it wouldn't be worth anything like £1,000. But that won't hold the lovely John back. All he's got to do is find out which bits of this computer need to be upgraded.
Well, that'll never work again.
Now all he has to do is get out his gothy calculator and his gothy pen and check out the prices of the upgrades he needs to buy from his local computer warehouse.
So I've done my sums, and I reckon I can build a £1,000 computer for just £400. All I need to do now is go to the shop and buy the bits.
So off he goes in his little gothy car.
Unlike the high street shops, there are some bargain wholesale computer shops in the middle of your local industrial estate. All you need to do is find out where they are. You'll get a very good deal, probably about half the price on the high street.
Well, here we are. With the aid of my trusty screwdriver, I've got this open. I'm not quite sure what's inside. Right, inside the old computer that I found, the processor chip is a little bit old, 33 megahertz. We need something about 10 times faster at least. And the hard disk drive is a 200 megabyte hard disk drive. We need something probably 20 times bigger than that now. So these two items have to be replaced. Also, we're going to need a new motherboard to put the processor on, and the memory, which is hidden down here, is way too small for anything we're going to need and won't even fit the new motherboard.
So what makes up a computer? Well, the processor is the computer's brain, the motherboard links up all the pieces of hardware together, the hard disk drive stores up all the software, the floppy disk drive for sticking your floppy into, the memory card which remembers what is where and where is what, the sound card for playing sounds, obviously, and the graphics card for, well, you get the idea.
So as you can see, it's starting to look a bit more like a computer. We've got a monitor, I've got the keyboard, and hopefully soon, we'll have a working system. And that's it. £1,000 of the computer for just £400. Now, all that's left to do is just to install the software. Once I've done that, it'll be just as good as any computer you could buy on the high street. That was the Goth Guide to Building Your Own Computer.
Oh, well, hey now. Nice hair, John. Reminded me a bit of Lamal from Kajagoogoo. And can we have our change back? Actually, you probably need to keep it. I don't think they still employ goths. Gia.
Now, you remember our young, upstanding...